goodness, guys. I looked all over the basement. My parents moved to this new house. I don't know what happened to my old Nintendo system, the old regular original NES. This is the last spot I haven't looked, guys. So far, no luck. I wonder if my parents gave it to Goodwill. Oh man, I do see some wires. There is some hope right here. Maybe the controller's in here. What the heck is all this? Whoa! Whoa, you gotta be kidding me, guys! I found it! Oh my goodness, it's not in bad shape, guys. This is the freaking original Nintendo Entertainment System. Let's look at this. This isn't the new one that came out. This is the original, regular size. Not slim, not miniature version. The Nintendo Entertainment System. Open that up. Oh, no cartridges. Oh man, I was hoping there's at least a cartridge stuck in there. Back then, we had to blow. If it didn't work, we had to blow on the cartridge or blow inside the system because it can get dusty. Oh yeah. Let's go ahead and make good use of that iPhone flashlight. And look at that. See the pins that it accepts? 1, 2, 3, 4. It's like 50, at least 50 of those copper pins. It's a fairly simple device, guys. Cartridge holds all the data for the games. See the power button and reset. I just hope that controllers and the power supply and all that stuff is somewhere. I believe these are the infrared sensors where you put in the controllers. There's a special hose to take into the video and audio controls. And this is way before USB or HDMI, guys. And I believe the LED light was orange off and green was on. Don't quote me on that, it's been a long time, guys. I haven't played this in freaking like over 20 years or so. See the audio and the video. Those are called the components. Wires, the yellow, red, and the white ones. That's before the composite ones. You see the AC adapter, the channel 3 and 4, you switch between the regular old school CRT TVs to make it work, and the AF switch, which is using the white ones. Alright, look at that design. It's like a freaking box. Look at that. One on the bottom. I wonder which one of this I got. It's number. I believe this is number 709,184. I'm guessing that's the number that was sold. So that's how many it was sold before that. Millions of units were sold, guys. Tons of it. Look at that. This came with the rubber padding. I'm surprised even back then in the 80s, 1985, look at this, guys. That's a long time ago. That is 32 years ago. Model number NES-001, which uses AC 9-volt battery, output power, 850 milliamps. 1985 Nintendo. AC adapter only, patent pending. Nintendo for customer service and warranty repair. I wonder if that still works, guys. Yes, Nintendo was originally founded in Washington State, and there is a Nintendo headquarters located in downtown Seattle. That's the area code 206. No longer have to dial 1, baby. That is the FCC ID, Nintendo of America Incorporated, made in Japan. You guys read all that. This is truly a collector's item, guys. What is this right here? So I do have the Rob with me in my house in Seattle. I'm just hoping that eventually my dad will be able to find the controllers. That would be awesome if he does. But I don't ever recall that I I wonder if they gave away the games, because I remember I had Mario, Super Mario, Duck Hunt. Ooh. I think I might have some Castlevania? I really don't remember, guys. Man, that's truly amazing. I'm very happy. At least I have the most expensive part of the unit. So once I find a controller and some games, I'm gonna definitely get this shipped back with me to Seattle so I can make some gaming videos only on the JRoo Productions YouTube channel. Alright, so I found this composite wire. Is this the original composite wire that came with it? Kinda looks like off color. I don't see any Nintendo brand on here. The white one looks like barely reaches the back. But this look pretty old, guys. This composite wire, who knows? This is probably not even 20 years old. But on the other end, you have this. Looks like plug into like a AC adapter or something like that. Doesn't look right. This looks like it goes into some type of port, like on a VCR or something. Something is fishy going on right here. Or maybe it's this one? Who knows? Look at the size of this beast compared to a Linksys EA7500 model router. Or even comparing it to a Patton portable heater, looking like it's part of the unit or its brother. And lastly, it's almost as big as a large USPS flat rate shipping box. Maybe when it's time to ship it, I'll be using the same box.